moment?
No.
But I am. I'm hiding behind him.
But if he were to cast Obscuring Mist, then they would be concealed.
Oh, yeah, that'd be... Well, wait. So, if you have Blur, you're just having concealment?
I don't.
Displacement.
I can check.
If you have Concealment, Big O, don't use it until we need it.
I have Obscuring Mist. That's it.
Don't use it right now.
Don't use it.
I can check on the Blur thing.
Don't move it till you see it.
Right.
Don't breathe.
That was quite a slow reaction time. Just like,
okay. Yes, you get concealment with Blur, which means you could use it to hide.
Two.
All right. Two.
Try the reaction time.
Okay. All right, so that's what you see. That's what you is going on in the room.
Okay.
Get him. Yay. Get him, boss.
Now I have to open all of this, all these tabs again.
So it's occurred to me that maybe the bad guys will respect my hiding more if I tumble everywhere.
Yeah, really be very impressed.
They have already heard the legend of Alistair, so they are already afraid.
So
the legend has, you know, spread throughout the land.
Nidia with the DC is to tumble.
To tumble what?
Forwards.
I tumble. I heard a song once. It goes, I tumble for you. I tumble for you. I
can we say 10?
For you.
If you'd like.
Great. So I'd like to be tumbling everywhere now. I'll take 10.
That would be marvelous. It does lower your movement by half.
Yeah.
So that's what you're going to do. And then when you're searching, that lowers your movement by half also. So you're going to be...
You think I can search while I move?
Yeah, taking 10, yeah. You can, but it's a 5-foot square.
Exactly.
You're going to roll into a wall.
Otherwise, you couldn't ever move anywhere.
It makes no difference. Yeah. So if I'm tumbling, do I get a bonus if I fall through a pit?
No.
Funny to watch Alistar run into, tumble into a wall. He does it all the time.
But I continue tumbling while I'm going into the wall. Like someone playing Grand Theft Auto. Just...
That'll be swell. Why don't you do that? All right, so... If nobody moves, that's exactly where you'll stay for all of eternity.
I can't actually see or touch it, so it might be like that for a while.
So, it's pitch black. What are you doing about light?
If you're casting light, you're casting it on yourself.
Are we actually entering, boss? Are we entering the door?
I don't know, I can't see.
We don't have any, like, you know.
I can see clearly now. Your laptop's gone.
Can we enter?
You're the only one that can't see.
Okay.
I'll suck to be able to see.
I'm gonna do nothing and just let them go ahead.
Okay. So you're gonna stay right where you are?
I'm a follower.
Is a door unlocked?
How do you know? You can't see him.
That's my phone!
And he's hiding. You can't see him.
It's like 2 inches of cord.
Here you go. Watch it.
Ready? Like, not do that?
Ready? Okay, good.
God.
Okay, search. Take 10.
Okay.
Then, yeah,
I'll let you know if you find anything.
Okay, I'm taking 10 on every square. That before I step in it.
Okay. Alright.
I want to go in.
Now,
I want to enter.
When you step into that square, a disembodied face appears before the door.
It's a trap!
Choose another path! This way leads only to death!
Death, we accept. You, we do not.
Hello?
I said it.
Is he blinking?
Nope.
No? Back, poke his nose.
It's gone after it says that.
Oh.
Great gasp.
Guys, this shit face showed up, said to go this way.
We all heard it.
Yeah, it said this way.
I heard it. I accept the challenge.
Challenge accepted. How do you know where you're going?
I'm following you.
If you're pitch black.
I'm a hug the wall.
You might get eaten by a Gru.
I'm a hug the wall.
Okay, you can do that.
You don't have it.
Wait, I have
Big
idea.
O, you don't have a torch or anything, dude?
Choose another path! This way leads only death!
That's what I thought would happen. Great, come back to this one. Let's do it again?
Yeah.
Woohoo! Guys, I think we can make like a band here.
I have heard of such devices that repeat. Some people call them recorders.
I think that if we like took turns stepping into the spaces between each of these doors, you just go choo 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 choo.
That sounds like fun. I want to do it.
It's going to continue saying it, so by all means, continue to alert the enemy.
Okay.
They're going to get alerted every time a squirrel walks in.
So can we go through
here.
One of the doors?
It's their problem.
Is the doors locked?
Yes, the door locked?
Yes, all doors are locked.
Okay. Great.
Can
I'd like to open the lock.
Okay, and what are you going to open it with?
Which door?
What's your open lock?
Plus 13. Taking 10.
Doesn't open.
Okay. Roll.
I like to ask the questions.
Okay.
All right.
Let's see.
Check.
King 10. Okay. You start taking 20 on every square. It'll take 20 times as long.
Yes, it will. More wandering encounters.
Let's go.
Okay, so hold on. He opens the door, and I will draw you in the next
seat. Open it, creak it open.
Oh, remember, I'm
hugging
the
wall.
Yes, you're hugging the wall. Choose another. Shut up!
I wonder if we kill the face to get XP. Also, do I get psychotherapy?
On the wizard? Yeah, he can't see you. He's denied his dex bonus to AC.
He is?
Yeah.
How much XP would I get for the wizard?
Only if he was an enemy. So you'd have to really piss him off.
Do you feel like an enemy?
We have defied him by not choosing another path.
No, not that one. That one.
That wizard.
Okay, so of course there's no traps there. Okay.
You detect the trap ahead of you.
Guys, there's a trap, I say in team speak. You learn team speak? Did you learn team speak?
He doesn't have to learn team speak.
Have you checked new languages?
He can't really hear you because you whispered it from another room.
I'm whispering it in that direction.
Wait, give me a listen check.
He is. Wait, what race are you?
I'm an elf. And that's 13.
Yeah,
you heard a whispering. It's a, what is that? Dude, there's a trap.
Oh,
but he doesn't speak team speak.
Okay. Well, then you heard Ricky.
Nope, he doesn't hear anything. But there is the fact.
So
it's sign language?
Sign language, then, yeah, you don't hear
You don't hear anything.
Yeah.
You hear... You hear my fingers swishing in the air.
I don't think he can
see. You feel a door on the wall ahead of you.
Let's just choose another path.
Hey, is everyone going
to
go choose another path?
Okay. Lock.
Okay, then I just keep hugging the wall.
Okay.
To get to the corner, then I hope.
All right. Okay, so what y'all do?
I would like to attempt to disable this trap.
Okay.
Take 10.
Cast in my dark companion right, to
what
break
does that
him to where we're
24.
At.
All right, that disables it.
Guys, I disabled the trap.
Yeah.
Sure is cool being a rogue.
Should I send my dark companion to hold his hand and guide him along?
Yeah,
do not
ahead.
Do that. It's not that kind of dark companion.
He does. He can always use a dark companion.
All right, I'm going to read this again. For your dark companion, because obviously the dark companion is not really.
What kind of trap was
good.
It? Is it pit trap?
A pit trap.
Cool.
He's just a -2 to all my enemies.
If he's an enemy, then you can give him a -2 and then you know where it is.
Alright, let's see. Dark companion. Okay. Alright, at 4th level, you can create an illusory companion resembling a panther spun from the darkness of the night.
That is not a great panther.
It stands with you in battle, hindering
your
enemy's defenses.
It can be any form
defenses.
I choose.
It's a panther.
I said it can be.
It has no real substance, therefore it can't attack or otherwise affect creatures or objects, therefore it cannot hold his hand. It occupies a 5-foot space. Any creature can enter a dark companion's 5-foot space without restriction. It must occupy its own space in order to have any effect on enemies. It's immune to any damage or other effects that might harm creatures. It can be dispelled or suppressed just like a spell effect. Can't create flanking. Does not provoke attack of opportunity. If it is more than 120 feet from you at the start of your turn, it instantly reappears adjacent to you. So you can send it up to 120 feet away, but it doesn't do anything.
And it won't trigger the traps.
It just gives.
But I'm mentally connected
to
it. I can't see what it sees, feel what it feels.
No, it doesn't feel anything. It's just like a statue.
Yes, hex blades do suck.
I like it.
But any creatures that are adjacent to it get a minus two on saves
so,
and AC.
So, hold on. You're saying you have a dark companion, and it sucks. And you like it when it sucks.
Yes.
Interesting.
I like it. It's
okay.
A dark companion.
Yes. All right. So, all right. You can actually see around the corner.
Woohoo!
Okay,
don't forget, I have my swords out. Wait, crossbows out. That way I can quick draw my swords.
Okay. Sorry, I have had a busy week. I didn't go over this again.
Okay, I'm going to go back to Borderlands then.
No.
Okay, I guess I won't go back to Borderlands then.
Okay.
I see four. I don't get why some of my numbers and stuff in my skills are underlined.
Don't know.
Can't wait until my base stack bonus is 6. That'll be awesome.
Yeah, it'll be wonderful.
Then I can... Crap, hold on a second.
Yes, you can.
I can't shoot with 4
crossbows.
You can
crap. No.
So, I can have as many free actions as I want, assuming it's the feat using free action as is described in Player's Handbook, right?
They got rid of free actions. You can have immediate and... whatever
yes,
the,
but that feat
doing?
Didn't.
You're doing.
So then, according to the rules in that player's handbook for that feat and such, I'd be able to drop my current crossbows and quick draw out 2 more crossbows.
I will look and
for
see.
Full attack.
There is not. You cannot do an unlimited number of free actions every round.
I guess I can't do an unlimited number. I think a limit of 3 would be perfectly
it's
reasonable.
Perfectly arbitrary. We will look at it and see what the rules say. So. Okay, so that's what you see, those of you who can see.
Great.
Those who cannot are in the corner, sulking.
Okay, so still searching.
Okay. All right. Okay, as you're moving up that way, you see a marble plaque on the door, fastened about human shoulder height.
Great.
So, let's see, you're in the dark. Give me a spot check, see from there.
Big O, you lost. Do you need help? Do you know where we're at?
Plus. 27.
Okay. You say it says.
I don't you look at my character sheet. I saw that.
No, I was going to ask him to go find him because he's lost.
He's right behind you.
He says.
You should pick him up then.
In this, it is pitch black. I can't see a dang thing.
Let him on your shoulders.
Come on. Let's roll. Grab my axe. Just don't cut.
That's
cut.
She's, wait. Hold on.
Just don't get cut.
Yeah.
Hey.
Okay. So the plaque says, in common, to pass this warded portal, you must face a challenge, mortal.
What if I'm not mortal?
I'm
only
mortal.
One way to find out.
I'm an elf, that's not mortal.
That's what you think.
Really?
They're mortals.
Aren't mortals humans?
No.
Nope. Mortals are. I'm
mortals
not
are people who are living who will at some point die. That's what a mortal is.
Technically, in D&D terms, it's someone with a soul.
Oh, okay.
No, it means you are living and you may at some point die.
I am immortal.
Devils and demons and other, you know, outsiders of those kind can die.
They're
they don't have
mortal.
A soul. They are not mortal.
If they are...
They can die of... If they cannot die of old age is another term.
If you can die, you're mortal. If you can... You're immortal.
That's right. That's the difference.
I think if you can't die, no matter what, it's invincible.
No, then, that means can't be harmed. Because, you know, you may be able to stay alive,
if
but if
heard
you're
of
invincible,
being,
like,
you said
you
can,
all
you can be vinced.
Sure.
Alistar, you never heard of mortally wounded?
I will mortally wound... You, okay?
Yeah.
So there.
Let me get my dark companion to fart on you.
Oh, I'm very scared. Okay?
Fart on him.
Guys, did you see read that?
It said, if we're mortal, keep going.
Yeah, okay, let's go.
Okay.
Okay.
Wizard,
so now,
touch the door.
Those of you who can see the plaque, and you see that it says, in common, to pass this warded portal, you must face a challenge mortal.
Oh.
But you don't see that.
Can I real quickly do a comprehend language that way I can hear his team speak?
No, because it's hand signals, and you're in pitch black.
Oh,
that's very true.
Okay.
It is intentional for that, by the way, though, because that may we don't have to talk. Like, they won't be like, here's someone chattering out the door, and I don't understand them. But they're going, this way we can get to you. Yep.
My mage armor is still in effect.
Yes.
Yeah.
It lasts for 5 hours.
And cool.
So far, it's been about an hour.
Yeah. Seems reasonable.
Okay. Wizard walks 6 feet forward.
Walk this way.
Okay, great. You smack into the door. So there's a door there.
Yes, there is.
Open the door, wizard.
My head.
I want to make sure you found the door. Yeah, you still have a cut on your forehead from when Kane scratched you. That's how a character dies, knows that though.
Okay. Why did Kane scratch you?
I pushed him out of the, did this and pushed him out of the
booth.
The tape. Yeah.
At lunch, yeah.
Okay.
Mitchell said, hey, I'm going to do something funny, and then shoved Kane out of the booth. Kane said, hey, I'm going to do something funny, and then tore Mitchell's glasses off his face and left a cut on his forehead from his fingernail.
Yeah.
And then went and moped in the library for the rest of the lunch. And then talk about he was planning on stabbing Mitchell.
Really?
Yes.
Nice.
Oh, and then
let's
he
go.
Also mentioned how much he hates that fat bastard, in his words.
Let's go.
Who always steals his food.
I vote we go.
I steal everyone's food.
You don't steal my food.
Because you never have food.
Very true. I still win. Open the door, wizard.
I open the door and walk in.
The door is locked.
The door is
okay,
locked.
I'll unlock it, then you can open it.
Okay.
10.
Doesn't open.
Roll.
Okay, hold on.
Can I detect secret doors?
Okay, when you try to open the lock and you fail, let's see, the trap goes off.
But I'm searching every 5 feet.
Yeah.
That's 5 feet.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So but I missed
Ben
it?
Did not find it.
Guess I'm gonna start taking 20.
All right, you appear, all of you.
Oh, okay, so we get to fight. I thought it was going to be like a pit trap or something. We all die. But this is way better. This song is a great song for us to get in a fight.
Don't dog my song.
What are you doing dogging it? I'm being honest. It's a great song for a fight.
Dang.
Tiny room, so we're gonna fight fire elementals. I don't know.
How do you know?
What?
How do you know?
I'm asking.
You'll find out with everybody else.
I'm gonna find out when you tell me. I need to put shoot to throw on my phone for whenever it becomes my turn. But my turn will probably only last like 30 seconds, and I won't get very far into the song.
What?
Okay, let's see. This chamber. Go ahead and put you guys here.
Okay, I'm hiding.
This chamber runs 20 feet north to south and 25 feet west to east. Near the east wall.
Look at that.
Stands a bronze statue of a warrior woman clad in plate armor and wielding a greatsword. Just as you absorb these details, the statue comes to life ready for battle.
Okay, I shoot it.
Hey, wait, baby.
So,
would you rather have some of this? I'm a lover, not a fighter.
What
did you think? Was she laugh at me? Did she laugh at me?
Well, considering she's an animated statue, probably not.
I'm just as hard as she is.
Want to bet?
Oh, that's horrible.
It's horrible.
You wear this basically like a blow-up doll made of metal, right?
Yeah, if it has holes.
Metal holes.
I've had worse.
Glass? Diamond?
Party appeared.
Pinecone.
on this wall.
Okay. 45.
All right, so let's see when she goes.
Kind of looks one of the pictures that my dad used to read me on stone tablets, cartoon tablets.
Hmm.
I think I can take her.
108?
We'll see if she let
me. All right, so Athros, your turn.
Big O.
And out the hole with the big O.
Give her the O.
I'd like to do another dungeon to see if I can figure out what. Wait, what could I use to figure out stuff about this? Knowledge Local?
Knowledge Arcana, most likely.
Okay, so can I roll with Knowledge Arcana to figure out anything about this?
Yes, you can give it a shot.
Eight plus eight, so that's 16.
You think this is an animated statue. It is probably physically dense and tough. So physical attacks may have difficulty.
I wonder if it's one of magic attacks.
Well, it depends on how you touch.
Okay. I would like to use my fire burst.
Okay.
On this axis.
So. All right. Let's see.
So I told you we could use a knowledge.
All right. Go ahead. Do your damage.
13.
No. You got to roll 3d6.
I wish I could roll a d20 for my damage.
I'm sorry.
3d6.
So I can roll 3d6 for my damage.
6. 7, 8. That's right.
So I'm going to take a wild guess and see if she's immune to sneak attack.
To damage?
So 12.
Do you have any bonuses to damage?
No.
Magic attacks don't tend to.
Unless I guess you use a staff or something like that as pluses.
I don't think that would be.
Not
either.
For this, it doesn't.
They were a war mage, maybe.
Okay, let's see. Alright.
So I do 12 damage to the animated stuff.
I mean, we could use a War Mage more than we could use a Hexblade.
Alright.
To become a War Mage.
We are David.
Okay. I mean, I'm David.
So the fires
came
upwards.
So you decided if I can have, at the very least, could
so
I
the fire
shoot this
room,
thing,
right?
Drop the crossbows,
for a second.
Stop turning your laptop at me.
Oh, wait.
And then pull out swords.
Hold on a second. We gotta. All right, look, you didn't even... I'm tired. I forgot he can't see anything.
Retcon.
Yes, retcon. I'm tired. I'm doing it.
Uh-huh.
He didn't lose any spell anyway, so... You didn't see a statue. I forgot you're blind.
But look, there's a glowy sword.
Well, then I...
But I'm going to let you keep your knowledge.
Okay.
Because you heard it creeping along.
But I cannot do the fireburst.
You don't... You're in a pitch black corner. That's all you know, is that you're in a corner.
How is it not working?
Wait, hold my hand.
So...
Does it have dark vision?
Yes.
So,
animated statues have dark vision.
So how about I just do fireworks on random access in the room, and that was random access, and just so happened to be access at
the time. You can go from the opposite
side. Can do the square right in front of you, if you'd like, instead.
Yeah, no.
Can you roll a random number and count the numbers?
He doesn't
numbers.
Even technically know that there's an encounter going on. So.
There's my head guy. You know, you could cast like light on something.
Yeah, I
guess
him, so he can tell me.
I guess I'm gonna have to hold
absolutely.
Big O's hand and
light
one of my torches.
Okay, so David, your turn.
Not still his turn. You took away his spell. He's still gonna do something.
I will let you have that. Then.
Maybe
you
could cast your light.
He's gonna let you have it. So
didn't
quiet.
He already cast his light before he rested?
No.
Yes,
you've already cast light.
Yes.
I did.
You cast light before the first time you entered into this corridor. And it lasts for...
I didn't cast light.
Oh, shut up.
I think you did.
On his helmet.
Yes.
Yeah, on a helmet.
No, we talked about doing that, and I
okay,
never
so
did.
You didn't. So you say you still have light.
Okay,
and
cast it on his
helmet. Memorized one time?
Okay, so I'll cast light on his helmet.
So I ain't blinded.
So now I can see.
Okay,
and
so
I
that
can't.
Was your turn.
Yes, you can.
Let's
it's not
how
daylight.
Long light lasts for.
Hey, what's going on?
Now you see that there's a statue moving towards the party.
All I know is you've all bend right, over
now
because
it's David's
we're going to
turn.
Take it up to
the
asshole.
Room's illuminated. Lasts for almost an hour.
Great.
It likes fast entry. Quick and out. No lube necessary. Right. We'll be going to fix
that. How do I insert more lines into my graph?
Does he enter?
No. So, how do I insert more lines into the thing?
Go to the end on the right and press enter.
I can't, there is no end on the right.
Okay.
It's cut off.
Alright. You're using Word?
WordPad. Don't have Word.
I don't use WordPad, I don't know.
Okay, then I'll just press enter and then start doing it in the same line.
Okay. That's great.
So. Okay, then, so damage for the crossbow is going to be a d8. Assuming it doesn't break any sneak attack.
No, which means it doesn't get your inch bonus to damage. Remember? You don't remember that. Complete warrior, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay. But my dark companion gets
anyway,
everybody minus
melee
2 to the enemy.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay, so maybe base attack bonus plus dex bonus?
To hit, yeah.
Okay. Then 20.
I'm a class 20.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that hits.
4 damage.
Doesn't seem to penetrate, bounces right off it.
AC 19.
That hits.
2 damage.
Bounces right off.
Could I drop the crossbows and pull out short swords? It is a free action. You pull out the swords.
Yes.
Okay.
Because you, well.
I do have quick draw. I could probably do it as one action altogether.
The problem is you took a full attack,
uh-huh.
Which means you no longer have a move. Don't pick your forehead. So you can drop them,
mm-hmm.
But you don't have a free move to draw the new one.
Don't need a free move. I have quick draw.
You do have quick draw.
Which makes a free action.
All right. I'll give that to you.
Okay. So shot it, drop the crossbows, pull out short swords.
Okay.
So now it won't get free attacks or whatever.
Okay. So that was now for Craig Griffin.
Let's go answer the question. See if it likes accents.
Sure wish we would fight something other than undead and stuff immune to sneak attack. That'd be great.
I'm attached to somebody.
Get him!
Okay, so now its AC is 2 lower and its saves are 2 worse.
Back to where
power attack!
Wow, that means its will save is minus 6.
Sounds good to me.
So what you're saying is...
Unfortunately, it's immune to mind affecting since it's mindless.
Okay, I'll use a will save poison.
Minus 3. Minus 2.
It is immune to poison as a construct.
I'll go for minus 2.
Okay, then I'll use an anti-evil poison.
Not
wait,
evil.
It's not evil.
Hmm.
I'll use a tactical nuke.
Sheet's acting up.
You're a sheet.
They coming.
You're a dead drunk.
It's because my phone's on.
Your character.
No, my phone was on the keyboard. It was jacking it up. Minus 2, 5.
Dark companions sucking. And your phone jacking up.
So
okay.
I got 18 to hit.
Okay, that hits.
Gravy.
I wish I had a plus 18 to hit.
D10.
D12.
Now I have a 12. Yep. 6 plus.
You didn't say you're doing power attack.
I did. I said minus 2, which still got 18 on it. So it gives me plus 2.
But did you actually say power attack?
Yes,
okay.
I did. I said power attack.
Ah,
like that.
Yeah, I thought you were trying to seduce me, so I ignored you.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
How rude.
Is that 1.5 times?
Whoa! That's nice.
1.5 times your strength damage.
Real party.
Plus double what you spent on power attack.
Because it's a double.
Well, that's real party.
My plus on strength is 4, so 1.5 times that
is 6.
There's one pretty shotgun.
Trying to concentrate. So 12 plus 6, right? 18.
Okay.
Hit points of damage.
All right. Looks like it shrugged off a great portion of that.
Right.
But you still managed to take a chunk out of it.
Yay. And piss it off at the same time. Which was what I was trying to do. I just want to get her attention. She should have rejected me like that.
Yeah, it can't get pissed off. It has no mind. All right, so
it can
its
pissed,
turn.
But it can get pissed off.
Well, it'll go ahead and attack you since you're the closest thing.
Great.
All right, so let's see. It is going to slam at you with its blunt sword.
That's all I wanted was physical contact. All
right, AC 17.
Yes.
Okay. 5 points.
Do I get a minus two on that for my dark companion?
No. The monster has minus two to saves and armor class.
But nothing on its attack.
Nothing on its attack. So 5 points of damage.
Yay.
Okay. It's actually size large. That's all right. We'll stick with what it's got. All right. Go... Let's see, Alistair.
Cool, Alistair.
Okay.
No. Winston. Sorry, Winston after.
Winston?
Winston after us. He goes first. He has a 21.
Winston.
You mean Big O?
Mitchell.
Mitchell. Sorry, wrote
Big
down the wrong one.
You ought to be very offended that he thought of you as Winston.
I am.
That's fine.
You should give him free XP.
He used to be offended. Bless you. Bless you.
Welcome to 2016 after the election.
Hey, in this country, according to the police, it is illegal to offend people.
Detect secret doors.
No, you cannot do both of those things.
Okay, so fire burst right here.
Okay, gotcha. All right.
That is nice.
Okay, do your damage.
One. Seven.
Two.
Seven. Thirteen.
Okay, that knocks it down.
Really?
Yeah.
Sweet.
It only had 20 hit points.
Nice. I wish I could have done something.
You did.
Sorry, I'm sure you'll say you took
you
it
shot,
out.
You shot, dropped, and picked up something.
Okay.
I put these up and I put them down.
I pick up the crossbows and reload them.
Sorry.
That's fine.
But I'm just thinking.
I couldn't resist.
So is it now dead?
It is now dead.
Okay, right. Luke.
Come
yeah.
How's he been cleave?
There was no loot to be found.
So it doesn't have any weapons?
It was apparently part of the statue.
And
so it has a stone sword.
Sure.
No, bronze sword.
It was a bronze sword.
Okay, I'll take it.
Okay, it is attached to its arm because it's a statue.
Fine. Okay, are there any rocks in the room?
There are no rocks.
Okay, then I'd like to beat it with its other arm.
Its other arm is also attached.
Oh, yeah.
It's a statue. It's a bronze statue.
Oh.
You cannot beat it with the other arm because it's a bronze statue.
But it's bronze. Alistair, isn't that worth money? How heavy is it? The totem.
Well, we were already carrying around two bronze statues.
Okay,
bases.
So the final decision is 11.
Okay.
Can we trade that if this is more valuable?
Give you any leeway whatsoever.
Yeah.
What?
What?
Who?
What are you talking about?
The final decision is 11. My brother can't come pick me up, but my curfew's fucking 12. No. They don't trust my brother.
We can play till 11.
They don't trust your brother?
They don't trust my brother. But we can play till 11:30. But my brother must spend the time with me, so 11.
He can spend 30 minutes with you.
We can roll up a character.
That's right. We can
slay for half an hour. We need a cleric.
He doesn't play this.
Right.
Yeah.
How old is he?
He is 18, 19.
Has he ever played Dungeons and Dragons?
No, he's 18. And I don't think so.
Does it matter?
Don't put off what you don't know.
Don't
knock it till you try it. Are you going to appraise the bronze statue?
Well, we can't actually get the stuff off of it, and there's no loot on it.
It is hacked. And so it has big wrench marks in it from an axe, and it's partially melted. And it's about 5,000 pounds.
But its arms aren't partially melted.
Okay.
That's what you're saying?
Was it wielding a weapon?
It was a statue of a warrior woman holding a sword.
Oh.
Now's your chance.
I have my way with the statue.
There are no available or five.
Yeah. You said there were red marks.
I cut into it, so I know this hole somewhere.
Yeah. I know exactly how desperate he is.
Fly, fly, fly so high.
So, now what?
I don't know. Now what, brave leader?
Great reader, great reader. Now,
We're sinking. What are you thinking about? What kind of juice you want?
Okay, so we're still in this room.
Yes.
Take 10 searching every single wall.
Huh? Let's see.
Coffee.
Okay, and what is your search?
What is your search?
13?
Sure, 14.
Okay. No, you don't find any.
Okay. So, in the time it takes me to search all these doors, every single space of wall, and we're still in here.
Well, it took you one round to do each square. So.
And there's, 5x4, so that's 5, 10, 18 squares.
Okay.
Okay. Guys, it's going to take a while. So taking 20 on every single door, or every single wall space.
Well, so put yourself where you're starting, and then we'll talk about it.
I'm starting in that corner.
Which corner? That corner. Okay.
Yeah.
And then which way are you moving?
Then I'm going to go to the opposite wall.
Okay, busting through the wizard.
Not that wall.
Go on this
wall. Yeah, that wall.
Okay, all right, so that takes 20 rounds, 20 rounds,
each.
20 rounds, 20 rounds. You guys feel yourself getting older. You're glad you're an elf because you're going to outlive.
Hold on a second, he's an elf.
Yeah, you still kind of feel yourself getting older.
Secret door.
Can I detect secret doors?
You're going to cast detect secret doors?
No,
yes.
The elves get a bonus.
Yes, I already rolled it.
So you're saying there is a secret door.
Do you have a spell to detect secret doors?
Yes, I do.
And you have it memorized?
Yes.
Oh, go ahead, cast it.
There's a door like that.
You just look it up in your player's handbook, but how long does it last? The person who's talking over the music? He needs to just go ahead and get a day job.
Yeah.
This is awful.
You know he got paid, though.
Not by me. Detect secret doors lasts for concentration up to 1 minute per level. Okay, so the wizard goes, dude, it's right there. He finds a secret door on that wall.
Good thing we have a rogue.
Uh-huh.
I would have gotten it eventually.
Eventually,
but it only taken me at most 36 minutes.
Okay. So, let's see. Okay, we got that. All right, and where's our map?
Where's our map?
Okay, so, now what? You know there's a secret door on that wall.
I'm going to move out the way so that the rogue can handle it.
Move! Move. Oh, get out of the way. Okay.
Okay.
Search the secret door for traps. Taking 2 minutes.
Taking 20. Well, you already searched that square and no trap popped up.
And no secret doors.
You know, because you were working your way around here, and that's when he cast the spell.
I mean, I was working my way on this wall and then that wall, but okay. I can see the problem.
You stood here, and I said, which direction are you moving? I said, this way, through the elf, and you're like, no, that way.
Okay. So then, no traps?
You do not detect a trap.
Yeah, okay, if there are any traps here, guys, it won't be my fault we don't see it. Okay, you can go primer for traps.
I don't think I can do that.
That's what I thought. Okay, so, then I would like to open the door.
Wait, I'm gonna back up just in case there is a trap.
Back taking time on every single square.
Should we erase all this?
Nope.
Okay. Just got moved. Probably would be in the way eventually.
Okay.
Let's roll.
Drive me forward. After surgery, of course.
Not touching.
Moving on forward. Moving forward.
If he sees, he wants you to move on.
Okay,
right
thank
there.
You. Great. Search.
You're not seriously going to take 20 every
no,
single square.
10.
Okay. Well, you don't find anything.
Okay, 5 foot forward.
Okay, looking around the corner. You see. Right here.
Why are you blowing? Are you vaping, Mitchell?
No, I'm holding my mouth shut and then burp and then blow.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying you like to blow?
All
right.
Like
let's rock.
I guess I'll sit over here so I can actually reach our mini. Okay.
Okay, so at about this time, does the light spell like go away though?
No, it lasts for almost an hour.
Okay. So I no longer have to like be attached
Church.
To you.
I'll let you know if your
okay.
take 10 manages to find anything.
That's why I was looking that way first. Okay. Open the door.
Okay, fall in the pit trap. That's right there.
And I didn't find it with my take 10 or take 10s.
Do you remember him saying now he's taking 10?
I said I was taking 10 before I stepped every
yeah,
time.
Yeah, I know. Okay.
He told me to tell me before I found the trap.
I know. Okay, hold on. Which trap? This one is.
I have a feeling that we're going around
actually,
in circles.
This is. There's a 5 foot. It's here.
Okay,
and
great.
Let's see if Take 10 found it. Hold on.
Either way, I have this strange feeling there's a trap right here. I don't know why. Maybe it's what this big black spot is.
I have a strange feeling that I'll start up, we're going around in circles.
I don't. I know where we're
yes.
going.
Yes.
Anyone else notice this door over
trap.
Here?
Okay, Take 10 to disable the trap.
Okay.
Right. Am I the only one seeing this door over here, guys?
Yes.
Yes?
Okay. You managed to disarm the trap.
Great.
Okay, so you have a corridor heading north there. Okay.
Still searching. Not there, 5 feet.
Okay. Again.
Open the door.
All right. Well, there's that room there.
How? I did it. Okay.
You open the door. Oh, stop. This is not the door. You will die.
Okay. Oh, wait, can I stand in there?
Yes, you disabled it.
Okay.
Okay, and ahead of you, that corridor opens up to a room.
Yeah.
That hallway ends with an open archway after about 10 feet. Hard for you to see exactly what's going on behind, but you notice some movement.
Fortunately, I have dark vision.
Yeah, hold on. Let's see. How's this doing? Okay. It's like the wall here. It's like it's the archway. It's like it flashes. Like it flashes as an opening for a second. Give me a spot check.
Twenty-four.
Okay, you think that the wall of the room ahead of you is spinning, and it's got an opening that you could actually, you know, you got through. but most of the time it's closed, and it opens and closed. So it's like you think there's a spinning room here, and just it opens for a short period.
Okay. Hey, wizard, come look at this.
That's what she said.
What is it?
A spinning room.
Okay, so let's see.
What are we going to do with this spinning room?
And it's oddly quiet.
I don't know.
All right, so what it says, the interior wall of the circular chamber beyond the archway rotates rapidly and silently counterclockwise. The floor of the room does not move. The entryway and the arch directly opposite are open for only an instant before being closed off by the moving wall. Protruding from the eastern wall, you can barely see it from there. About 5 feet away from the opposite archway is a lever.
You know what would be really cool? What if we dragged the statue over here and then stuck it in the opening whenever it came in?
It's too heavy.
You don't think that all three of us combined could drag it? Pounds.
He has an 8 strength.
Okay, I have a 14 strength. And what do you have?
18.
Yeah, and together we could do it. What's gonna work?
Remember, it's a size large bronze statue.
Yeah, we'll roll it.
Can't get through the secret door.
Certainly looks like it's 10 feet wide.
The secret door is not 10 feet wide.
Okay, so what we'll do is we'll all heave it up and throw it at it. And it's so fast, it'll break the wall.
Do we have anything in that we could... So the wall...
You should put your great axe in there. That's a great idea.
It is possible to jump through the archway while it is open.
Yeah, I know, but I have a feeling that some of us who are wearing heavy armor or something like that, they'll get cut in half. Maybe some of us who aren't that fast.
Can we just use rope and...
No, we can't use rope.
Is it a doorway? What is it?
Okay, then I'd like to jump through.
Okay, hold on. It's a spinning room. So yeah, jump across the spinning room. Is that it?
Yeah, I go in pit trap. That'd be the perfect trap. Yep. It's this amazing jump, like whoosh. Pit trap! Don't let me fall!
Okay, so this interior wall is rotating. The floor is not moving.
Okay.
This doorway and this doorway are impeded by the moving wall. It's rapidly rotating. You're going to go ahead and jump through?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on a second. All right, let's see. Give me a dex check.
Or else what?
Roll dex a d20 and add your dexterity.
It's not reflex, though.
It is a dex check. Tumbling skill can be used instead of raw dexterity.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead.
22.
Okay. So you made it into the room.
Okay. Is there anything you can... I'll start. Is there anything you can use to trigger this to stop the wall?
There's like a lever or something.
Okay. There is a lever on the wall.
I would like to use my amazing reflexes to pull it so that the room would stop with the doors actually, letting people
okay. go through. Pull the lever, causes the wall to slow down and stop, so both archways are open.
Great. Yes. So that's good.
Unfortunately, the lever was trapped and the ceiling falls out.
Yeah.
Boulders rain down. And you die.
So we just want to guard this door.
Well, he's already stopped it. He triggered it.
Anything else in the room?
No, there is the, don't put yourselves up there yet, because you got to draw what you're going to see.
Great. Back to Borderlands.
No hidden passageways, no treasure.
So we're just going to ignore that door back at the end of the hallway?
Yes.
Apparently so.
I don't see any doors.
I saw a door.
I didn't see any doors.
I saw a door.
I think you're imagining it.
No, the guy with the lit helmet was standing right behind me. I saw it.
The what helmet?
The lit helmet.
You're saying his helmet's lit?
Yes.
Tell me, is it also by any chance kind of dank?
What is dank?
Dank names.
What are these dank
memes? You can thank me later.
What are these dank memes?
Oh, that's sir, that is not a part of my vocabulary. Could you please teach these
Use
words
Google.
To me? What is Google?
Google is this magical place where you can learn
sir,
amazing.
Sir, I am a wizard. I'm pretty sure I would know of Google if it was a magical place.
Okay, then what is it?
That's the problem. I don't know what it is.
So you don't know what it is, but you're going to tell me what it's not.
I would know anything that is magical.
Really?
And...
everything?
Like, y'all really pissing me off right now.
How much?
Alistar and Big O want to... y'all causing a lot of sexual attention.
Just go find your statue.
Okay. Are you getting hard over there, sir? Are you seeing Medusa?
Okay, hold on.
Where? You see Medusa?
Are you seeing Medusa over there, sir?
Well,
that's a small door.
You're a small door.
Yeah, you can just put me behind him. There you go.
Searching door, taking 20.
I'm gonna stay here just in case something comes up behind us until they get to the door.
Or until it triggers and cuts you in half.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay right here.
There you go. Good boy. There you go.
Okay. The door does not appear trapped.
Okay. Is it locked?
Yes.
Open the lock, taking 10.
Okay, and taking 10 gives you a 24.
23.
Yeah, it doesn't open.
Roll.
Doesn't open.
Roll.
Yay,
I unlocked the door, guys.
Crazy.
I'd like to open the door.
Okay.
Okay,
open the door.
Meanwhile.
Can I move further down the hall?
Meanwhile.
Recorder.
Ooh, a rocket launcher.
Yo, this song is lit.
What is this lit you speak of? Is this a dank meme?
What is a dank meme?
What is a lit?
A lit is something that is awesome.
I've never heard of this vocabulary term. I may be one of the most intelligent people in the world, and humble too, and I've never heard this lit before.
Well, how do you think I feel? I'm an elf, and I don't know what Google or dank or memes or dank memes. What are these words that you are speaking to me, sir?
Dank memes are the only reason to live.
If they're the only reason to live, why do I not know about them?
I basically cut one of y'all in half. It all depends on which one's the closest. Looks like you.
Sure. I'm going to go right there.
So I have to ask you to calm down.
Sir? I need you to stop talking to me.
I have to ask you to relax. This guy is a sword.
Sir, why is your accent different?
What?
You have a different accent.
We have different accents.
You have the same accent at all times. So I'm standing here looking into the room, and it's supposed to be a circle, but it looks more like an egg.
Okay.
Alright, so you open the door. In a regularly shaped room, this chamber extends 20 feet north to south and up to 35 feet west to east. There are two alcoves. There are two alcoves, one each in the northern and southern walls, both about 25 feet into the room. The easternmost wall narrows and steps to form a 10-foot wide, 5-foot deep space. Suspended from an iron chain in the center of the space is a 1-foot diameter red crystal sphere. Beneath the sphere is a 3-legged round table. Carved into the top of the table are 10-inch diameter circles at the ends of spokes, forming a ring around an 11-inch diameter circle. Stacked neatly in the center circle are 11 gold coins. A number, 1 through 11, is imprinted on each coin.
Numbers on the circles.
Hold on a second. You don't know because they're covered by coins.
A coin in each circle.
Finally got
no. The gold coins are, sorry, in the center circle, and there are numbers on the outside on the circle.
Okay, then I'd like to put a coin that says 1 in the circle. It says 1.
When you touch the coins, a voice speaks from the red crystal sphere. 10 and 8, 8 and 10. Arrange the coins or face death again.
Again?
10 and 8, 8 and 10. Arrange the coins or face death again.
I like to put 1 in the 1.
10 and 8, 8 and 10. So I'm 18. Guessing you put a coin that says 10 on a slot that says 8. And the coin that says 8 on a slot that says 10.
I was going to wait until I get to 7 and then decide what I'm going to do with those.
No, I think Big O is right. Let's do that.
Great. First, however, I'd like to put a 1 in the one that says 1.
No!
Why?
Because that's what the riddle said. We go with the riddle.
I'm pretty sure they were just trying to rhyme.
No.
10 to 8, 8 to 10.
Do it.
So 2.
10 to 8, 8 to 10. Damn. I think it's number 10. All of these popping 8.
Coins.
Number 8, and I'm popping it into 10.
Back up.
2-8.
I'd like to use Knowledge Dungeon to figure out what this room is.
Nope.
No?
Doesn't give you any information. All right, nothing happens when you put the 1 coin there.
So nothing happens when I put 1 in the 1?
Nothing happens when you put the 1 in the 1.
I want to put the 2 in the 2.
David.
I just got through saying I was put 8 to 10, 10 to 8. Nothing,
yeah, you did.
Okay, what I'm gonna nothing do happened. Is I'm going to draw here. That's the center where the coins were. And then there's here, here.
Okay, let me know
what
you're
doing. Let you what?
You
know.
Okay. And there. Ooh, is that a nice shield? Nice shield. Oh, I'm not dying. I don't like dying.
Oh, they didn't say bullshit.
What?
You're supposed to say bullshit. And they are connected with lines.
I think it's the feminist fault that it didn't say that.
Well, the original song did. When they released, they blamed it.
Goes wrong, blame the
no, when something is censored, blame the feminists. And when something is wrong.
So there's only blame 9 outer circles?
There are 10 outer circles and 1 inner circle.
You didn't draw 10 outer circles. Did you?
Uno,
they
dos,
did.
Tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez.
They did. So what happens when we put the 8 in the 10 slot and the 10 coin in the 8 slot?
The circles do not have numbers on them. Only the coins have numbers on them.
So I have to guess.
First, I'd like to put the 1 coin. The coin says 1.
Is there any sort of marking on any of the circles that decides which is the first one?
No.
Put a coin in a slot.
It'll be
right.
All freaking
the number
dead.
In the circle.
What am I going to
write
with?
The number in that circle.
What am I going to write with?
This is like an endless puzzle. We don't know that that's actually 1. Just because you put it there doesn't make it that.
The most tries I could possibly take is 11 to the power of 11.
Which is a lot.
Yes. We'll get it eventually. Hope you brought food. Okay.
Oh, crap.
Did I do anything?
I don't think 1.
You're actually right there?
Yes, it's not a very good marker. There, 1.
Okay. Nothing happens.
Okay, I'd like to take it out of that one. Okay. 1.
Nothing happens.
Can we just, say that we
1.
Did it? How much time will it take? We've tried 1 each one of these things and figured out which one's 1 through 10.
Maybe there's a penalty for failure.
Take 10.
No, it's a puzzle. Take brain.
Yeah, it makes absolutely no sense, though. So, yeah.
I mean,
hold on a second. There's a crystal ball in the ceiling.
Okay.
Maybe that has something to do with it.
I'll describe the room again. All right, we know what the outlines of the room are. Suspended from an iron chain in the center of the space is a 1-foot diameter red crystal sphere.
Yeah.
Beneath the sphere is a three-legged round table. Carved into the top of the table are 10-inch diameter circles at the ends of spokes, forming a ring around an 11th-inch diameter circle. Stacked neatly in the center circle are 11 gold coins. A number, 1 through 11, is imprinted on each coin.
You know what they'd never expect? What if we just took the coins and left? Okay, so I'd like to...
What use would they be to us? They got numbers on them.
They're still made of gold.
Yeah,
so I'd like to go up and try to grab the ball from the ceiling.
Okay.
Is there any other clues or anything that can tell us which one's what number?
All right. The trap activates automatically when the tampers with the sphere. All right. So the fireball goes off.
Oh, reflex save.
Well, I'm not even in that room, so.
You're right there, dude.
Yeah, but didn't you say it's...
No. Right here.
Oh, well, I hate you.
Okay, reflex save 27.
Okay, everybody else reflex saves.
Evasion! No damage!
I don't know if I have any evasion.
19 plus dex?
Mm-hmm. Plus, no, oh, it's 19 plus a reflex save.
I got 1-0.
Okay.
Reflex save is the bottom left-hand corner of that.
So 19 plus dex is 22.
All right. Let's
hold
see.
On. Yeah. Yeah.
DC hold on a second. I can't math. 15, so you'll take half.
Take
you
all.
Didn't save, so you'll take all. And you'll take none.
Woohoo!
All right, you guys
being
want,
a rogue is
great. It's only 5d6.
If only we had a healer.
God,
damn it.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'm fine. Yeah.
I hate you.
Hey, how did I know it would blow up?
When there is a giant crystal ball,
you don't
you
touch
usually
it.
Assume that it's a freaking trap.
When a god asks
you
if you're a god, you say huh? Yes!
17 points of damage. 8 points of damage.
Nice.
He nimbly dodges out of the way of it.
Busted!
I hate you. I hate you.
All right, the crystal sphere shatters, and a key made of some strange reddish metal falls onto the table.
Ta-da!
So we were supposed to touch the ball.
No, you were supposed to solve the puzzle, at which point the sphere would disintegrate and drop the key.
I got the key!
Explosion.
Look, guys, I solved the puzzle!
Yay. Yeah,
you did.
How do you know?
I would like to pick up 5 of the coins.
Okay.
I'm sorry, we need to divide those. So who would like
he
to
said,
have
he said okay with me picking up 5.
Sure. You pick up
I am sorry,
like,
but I am party treasure.
I am picking up 5.
And I am picking up my axe.
Yeah, exactly.
5 to the treasurer.
Yes. So, there are 11 there.
Okay.
So now we can either divide this up in silver. Or put the excess in party treasury,
just
which we do.
Just put it in treasury.
Okay, so there's 3 of us. That'll just... 3 and... Okay. 3 gold for you. 3 gold for him. 3 gold for me. 2 in party healing fund.
Okay. I'm whatever.
I want to write that down in character.
I think you should give us your gold pieces for me cause and have a hit point damage.
Yeah.
Would you like my 3 gold?
Yes.
Okay. He can have 2 because he took more damage.
Yeah, I know. He can have 2, I'll have 1.
Oh.
How sad.
To have gold only to lose it all at once.
So I hear the next one. Alright.
Yes. Enjoy. Don't spend it all in one place.
Alright. How many hit points do you have? Don't look at his character sheet, screen speaker.
I'm sorry. I try very hard not to.
25.
If he doesn't like it, maybe.
25.
You didn't get the cleric to heal you up after the troll thing?
No, I actually gained an extra 4.
Not you. You.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Hexblade sometime.
I got my own special healing ability.
Really?
Yeah. I have sex with metal statues.
When
it heals it heals me.
Well, I mean, you're hurt. You should go do that.
Might as well.
They're rejected him.
Even when
hey,
it's dead?
Hey, there's a metal statue all the way over here. It's dead, though.
Okay, so I wonder what we're supposed to do with this key.
I get iron from it.
Hey, guys, Maybe we should,
I guess I can't.
Guys, remember that door at the end of the hallway?
Yeah.
Maybe we should go check out that door.
Nah, so what's to the left?
Nothing. Look, it ends. Look.
I see.
Find the secret door.
Oh, look at that! I'd like to check the secret door for traps.
Okay,
look, open the secret door. Trap activates. Perfect. Look at how beautiful that is.
Yes.
You used water erase, didn't you?
Uh-huh.
So beautiful.
I love it. That's too much! You monster. Yep, just for that? That's what you
Will you stop?
Want to stop what?
Putting wet stuff on my laptop?
That would
be great.
I put it dry side up.
That's what she said.
Okay.
I'd like to.
Got dip? Well, I'd like to walk over to you.
Okay.
And another one.
Okay.
Another one.
Alright.
Nothing.
Okay. All of a sudden, when you step into that square, gravity inverts,
what?
And you fall 30 feet up.
Tumble! Ha!
Go ahead.
Okay. 24!
Okay, that allows you to treat it as 10 feet less. So
20
you only
feet.
Take 2d6.
Okay.
6 points of damage.
Oh no! So injured.
Okay.
It's gonna be like that. 10d6.
Okay, up above you, it was a 5-foot by 5-foot corridor. And then when you fall, you're basically there's a door next to you.
Interesting. Guys, I'm floating.
Hey.
Well, no, you're not floating. To you, you just fell up and landed in at the bottom of a pit.
So
as
soon as we entered that corridor, gravity changes for us, too.
Just me. I'm going to start walking on the ceiling going, giant steps on, what you would think.
Okay, I want you to imagine for a second.
Huh?
Okay. You're in an area of reverse gravity. You fell up 30 feet. To you, you're looking down at the corridor, but really, it seems like you're looking up at it.
Yeah. My character has never even considered this before. He is so amazed. Like, walking in here and like...
It just feels like you're walking around.
Yeah, but suddenly the floor is on the ceiling.
It just feels normal.
No, it feels like there's a floor on the ceiling.
No, it looks...
With a door?
Like
with my party members on the other side of the door?
No.
Standing on their version of ceiling. Or my version of ceiling. Uh-huh.
There's a door here.
And look at that!
They're not on the other side of the door. They're not on the other side of the door.
Secret door. That door.
Okay, they're not on the other side of that secret door either.
Oh, really? He's not?
They are not.
They
he is.
They is. Great, I would like to check the door for traps.
Okay.
So how do we get to him?
That is the question.
Do we step on the same tile that he did?
That's a great idea.
Okay.
I gotta fix the
door. Is that what you're gonna do?
No,
I'm
not. Staying in the room until
falls on
I
my
know
head.
The short head first.
It's not safe.
There. Okay. You pick 10.
Can you just jump back down?
It's 30 feet.
Okay. You take 10,
right.
You do not find a trap.
Okay, let's open the door.
Okay. Dispel magic trap goes off. Pick 10 was not high enough to find it. Dispels the reverse gravity. Fall 30 feet to the floor.
Okay. 34.
Okay. So now you only take 2d6.
Hold on.
Yeah.
So you only, no matter what, have it be 10 feet low, 10 feet less.
Yeah.
A natural point.
6 points of damage.
Oh, no. So much damage.
So much damage.
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and drink that potion. Yeah, I'm going to bring a potion.
Really?
Yeah.
How much potion is it?
D8 plus 1.
Oh, yeah, I missed what Will said.
V8 plus 1?
Yeah.
Dank! So I'd like to...
What the frick is dank?
Look it up on Google.
I don't know what Google is.
Well, look in your wizardy book. I'll keep him occupied for a while. So, it's in there, I guarantee it. Start in the beginning. So, what's on the other side of the door?
The door's up that way.
Mm.
30 feet.
Okay, well, I'd like to climb the wall.
Huh? Huh? All right. Give me a climb check.
Sir, Google is not in that book.
Look again. Okay, 19.
Check climb UCs.
If only we knew someone here who could climb really well.
I have a rope of climbing.
We have Harambe.
I have a rope of climbing.
We have Harambe.
You don't have Harambe, you do have a rope of climbing.
Exactly.
I do have a rope of climbing.
What does it even do?
I'm give it a command.
Climb stuff.
You give it a command, and it will snake itself up into the air,
mm-hmm.
and it will attach itself. Or if it doesn't attach, you can still climb it, and it adds to your climb check. And then it will detach itself with another command.
Hey, wizard!
Wait, so if it when it detaches, will it just go back to my back there?
Fall back down and then pick it back up.
Okay.
Well, you can hold on to it while it attaches.
Yeah, or it can do that.
Alright.
So could you climb up it, and it's like 30 feet up in the air, say. And then when you get to the top,
mm-hmm.
like when you're holding the top, mm-hmm. say detach, and then while it's detaching and you're 30 feet up in the air, so it reattach, and the other end shoots 30 feet up in the air. It's going, like that.
It will not do it fast enough to stop you from falling and killing yourself.
So it'll be like one of those Spider-Man things. You shoot the ball and it goes...
No.
That was a fun
one. Yeah,
alright, so...
Except for the falling 30 feet every time.
A rough
yeah.
surface, such as a natural rock wall or a brick wall, was a DC of 25. You failed by more than 5, so you fell.
Fortunately, I didn't make it up anywhere, so I didn't fall anywhere.
That's why I was only going to make you fall 10 feet.
Tumble.
You didn't even look.
I did. It's a 14. Would you like to see?
No, I'd like you to look in the future.
I did.
I would like 26. To use my rope of climbing to attach to the roof that's right in front of the door. And then
right?
climb up.
Hey, to bring it to you, but I can see things very quickly. That's my CSGO reflexes.
Yeah.
So
okay.
That's...
The rope snakes upward.
I'm like Captain America and Deadpool. I see faster.
I feel faster.
No, I see faster.
Roll a d20 for climbing.
Let's see. Hold on. I'll tell you. I think you get a plus 5 for having more than climbing.
By the way, I guess basically, I managed to climb 15 feet up perfectly fine, then fall off the wall, and then tumble when I hit the bottom and take no damage, and then stand up and go, ta-da!
Okay. So as you are climbing your rope of climbing, make it up the first 10 feet, and then the reverse gravity kicks back in, and you fall 20 feet up, and because the bottom of the rope is not secure anywhere, only the top, so you can just imagine.
Hold on a second, I climbed 15 feet up.
Correct.
The reverse gravity didn't kick in.
No, took 4 rounds.
So we all follow it.
Only the ones that are in that square, which is you and him.
Whee! Tumble.
Okay, so you have tumble? Probably not.
No.
26.
Okay. So you only take 9 points of falling damage.
Can I use reflex save to dodge the ground?
No.
Okay.
This doesn't look too good.
Okay, so... you weren't in that square yet. So you see them bouncing up and down in this thing.
Okay, I'd like to use the door.
Okay, the door is locked.
Open the lock.
Okay, let's see. Okay.
Are they up or down?
Like, just like before.
I'm holding on to the door this time.
The same trap goes off.
What? I'm holding on to the door.
Because you activated it by trying to open the door.
Nope, I'm holding on to the door.
Absolutely, you are. However, he...
I'm holding on to my rope.
Absolutely, you are holding on to your rope. The 50 feet of rope. You're holding on to one end. The other end is secured up there. Back down you go.
Now I'm going to back up.
I hate you.
Perhaps it's my fault.
6 points of damage. As holding onto the rope, you plummet back down to the floor.
I'm holding onto the door handle, like,
I'm hanging on to 10 feet into the rope.
Why didn't say that?
Because I climbed up 10 feet.
You didn't? Well, okay, so,
yeah,
so just...
So I didn't fall and hit the ground, I fell down 5 feet.
5 feet does no damage.
Yeah, 5 feet.
Alright, take off the damage. You're dangling from your rope. I give that to you, especially since it's a magical rope.
So
I'd like to climb up my rope again.
Okay.
Really?
Can we?
No. No.
Now I'd like to open the lock.
I think it would be wise to anchor part of the magic rope to something else. So
I think it'd be wise to anchor it up here so I could hold on to it.
It won't be falling. You'll be holding onto a rope to secure.
Joe, can you hold the other end of the rope for me?
I suggest we find something else to tie it to so I can climb it too.
Okay, rope of climbing. 60 feet long. It's no thicker than a wand, but it's strong enough to support 3,000 pounds.
Hold on. We could use it to drag the statue.
The rope snakes forward.
Yes, brilliant.
Downward, downward, or in any other direction at 10 feet per round, attaching itself securely wherever its owner desires. It can unfasten itself and return in the same manner. It can be commanded to knot or unknot itself. This causes large knots to appear at 1 foot intervals. Knotting shortens the rope to a 50-foot length until they are untied, but lowers the DC of climb checks while using it by 10. A creature must hold one end of the rope when its magic is invoked.
So it's technically tied by magic to something.
Yes.
So it wasn't loose.
The bottom was loose. The top that snaked up attached to a ring that's up at the top.
Hey, could I attach both ends? Like, the bottom part is attached to the roof down climbing to. Can I attach
the other, send the other up, and then it'll be
attached
dangling down.
And be 25 feet instead of 50 feet.
That's a 30-foot thing, so it's only 5 feet up, but that should be reachable.
Okay, so
let's
now instead of just a rope going down, it's like...
And it'll act like an escalator.
Okay, yeah, I'd like to do
it
that.
It won't act like an escalator. All it does is knot. No. It's knotted. The two ends are knotted up at the top.
But it won't let you... It won't elevate. It won't go around in a circle like this.
No.
No,
I
want to
go.
Instead of now falling all the way back down, I'm just holding on to a loop.
Fine.
Okay, so you...
So technically, it would have fallen the first time. Experience that
no.
Night.
The first time he sent it up, and as he was climbing, the magic came back in. Basically, he was holding onto a rope, looking down into a 30-foot pit.
but the second time, whenever gravity was
again
replaced, I only fell down 20 feet, not the full 30, so I didn't get any damage.
Let's go up the magic rope and open the door.
All right, so you guys are hanging from the magic rope. And you are trying to open locks on the door, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Trying to open lock, sets off the trap. Again, reversing gravity.
Unfortunately, I'm still holding on to it.
I'll never let go. I love
you.
You
know, Avatar has got a disabled device on the door.
You should probably try to do that. Okay. What'd you get?
Not enough. 22.
Not good enough.
Fell by 5?
Yes.
How many times can you try?
I would like to use knock.
Okay.
Just knock on the door.
Alright.
Thanks.
I'm tired of this.
Okay.
Wait till you see what happens now.
Well, yes. Something.
The trap goes off, reversing gravity.
No. But the door does not open, surprisingly enough.
But knock unlocks anything that is magically or physically sealed.
I agree. It seems like perhaps there's a special key that's going to have to open this door.
I put the key in the door.
Made me waste my knock.
Did I ask you to knock it on it?
No, but this is your fault.
Guy.
Okay, give me a spot check.
I'm only one allowed
21.
Okay, the keyhole is yellow.
Right. We have a red key.
Not the key's red?
You guys want to go try that?
Climb
door?
Down the rope. Go down over here. Okay. Find the secret door that's there.
Okay.
Rinse and repeat.
All right.
Bring the rope over here.
Oh, yeah. I would like to grab my rope and put it in my backpack.
Okay.
You're still on the rope, by the way.
You're not in my backpack.
Just kidding, by the way.
Okay.
I can pay a treasure catch. Oops.
I rolled. You did not find the secret door.
Great. I know it's there. Take 20.
Okay. You find a secret door.
Amazing. I had no idea it was there.
Wait. You're all the way over here, though.
No, I'm not.
They're buying the room.
No, no, no. This wasn't supposed to happen. Stand by.
Ooh.
Interesting. I appear to be dead.
You ought to pay attention.
Yeah, no, I just lost $7,000.
It's almost there like there's go. A game going on the future.
Yeah, I know. I wonder why. I just can't shake that feeling. It's almost as if there's some giant god thing still drawing in the map.
I feel like our leader is being
okay, great.
Is distracted.
Now I would like to walk over there, get the wizard to use. I'm sorry.